You're up pretty late, Cody. Oh. Oh, he's off this week, though, isn't he? He's alright.
Well, to begin with, it wasn't his first arrival. Very few know this, but Freyr was one of the earliest visitors to Alfheim, back in the dawn of realm travel.
Ah, he'll be fine. He's alright, he's a big boy.
We believed for a long time
he can deal with a little bit of smash, you know?
Died in the flood, until one of them appeared in Vanaheim. Her name was Gerd, and she came offering to teach us the secrets of traveling between realms using Bifrost Light.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that path, which must mean...
Another Hafgufar.
Odd. It looks as though the Light Elf sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess is in hand.
Wonder if you'll partake in some Call of Duty there on the weekend. Lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
Now, I messaged him last week when we were planning on playing, and he never got back to me about playing COD, so. I didn't want to bug him, so I just kind of left it.
I remember when Freyr and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hafgufa. But I have to believe in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. Well. Best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave.
We're gonna go deal with those first. I feel like fighting a boss like right away. I think the first playthrough I went through on this too, I accidentally took Atreus through this area, so it's gonna be interesting because I'm doing it with Freya this time.
Jewelry.
Oh? Put it on one of my horns. Let's see if I can pull it off.
No.
I think I remember this boss, so I'm not ready to get smashed. Although I have Freya here, so I'm fine.
An elven library.
An archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day. You can browse at our leisure.
I'm gonna go double check up here.
These texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War. But restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of Odin's book.
Aye. Quite the advantage for the Light
Elves. Alright, Cody. Have a good one, buddy. Thanks for dropping by. Another primal plane, nice. Have a good one, buddy.
This knowledge of their ancestors, their shared history, poetry, just sitting here, forgotten. What a waste.
This book is sealed, but there is an inscription. The console.
Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text. What's that?
A diagram for a sword hilt.
Perhaps we should show it to one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do with it.
Ah, it appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Thalborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
Shield strike!
I want my blades, please.
Knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
When last we traveled here, after Faye passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people. I do not wish to make the same mistake twice.
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture, it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track then.
Freaking door. Jeez.
Thank you.
no effect. Perhaps a different arrow. This kind of hive material is sensitive to sound. How odd. Last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was
the point of that.
Aye, and as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the light well, or even our trapped Hafgifer for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
More hive, but denser. Too thick for that. Well, there you go.
Another wretch to the left.
Enemies on the left. The Alpha. Enemy behind you.
Back.
territory changes hands often. Now also it appears.
Big Vier did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corps below would disagree.
What are you doing, eh? Good girl? Man, they get so much hack silver in new game. Crazy.
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we? The lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
Thank you.
that's happened. Perfect. For what? For what? What's happening? Yeah? Tell me more. Hey? What's happening? You alright, Athena?
To comprehend the choice they face.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hofgufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Given another chance. I know what choice I would. Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Thank you. fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame.
Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but, well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now, don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Years we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim.
Getting done in by a